Students, welcome you all for the fourth class of first chapter, that is course. What did we study in the previous class? In the previous class, we have studied about principle of moments, that is sum of anti-clockwise moments is equal to sum of clockwise moments, and even we have solved some of the important equations which 100% surely it comes for your exam, that is mass of a ruler. So in mass of a ruler, we have come across a word called center of gravity. You remember that. So our actual today's topic is nothing but center of gravity. What actually is center of gravity is, we need to study about it. So before going to the topic of center of gravity, let me conduct a simple what we call illustration or simple experiment. See, can you see all this? This is a notebook what I have taken. There is a notebook in my hand. Now, in a finger, just in one finger, if I want to balance this, can I balance in this position? In this position, can I balance? No. If I try to hold the book in this position, it is going to fall propwise. Is it not? It is not able to withstand. For example, if I try to balance at this position, what happens? It is going to fall in the anti-clockwise direction. But where is the position I can hold this book in order to be in equilibrium, the reception? Let me try now. Look at here. See, I am able to rotate this book. But can I able to rotate it here somewhere? No, it's not at all possible. Can I able to rotate the book in this position? No, it is also not possible. But why I am able to rotate the book exactly when it is at middle? See, look. How can I able to rotate it? What is this position called as? Above this, we are going to study in the next half an hour. It's a very easy and an important topic for your even examination. I hope you have understood this condition. Based on this condition, I have taken an examiner's book itself. Then I will be explaining to you what we mean by center of gravity. So now, let us consider an object book as an example. See, in this entire chapter of center of gravity, entire concept of center of gravity, I will be taking book as an example. You can take any of the examples. Once if you have understood the concept of what you mean by center of gravity. For my opinion, I have taken what you mean by book. So before going to the topic of center of gravity, let me explain you what are some of the important concepts which I want to explain to the center of gravity. That is, this book is considered to be an object. Or book is considered to be an object. It is made up of atoms. Is it not? See, every particle in the universe is made up of atoms. Like, if this is a book, if you consider, it is also made up of what? It is also made up of atoms. This is made up of what you mean by atoms. Is it not? Yes. This book has some weight with which the earth exerts the pull on it towards the center. See, in your 9th standard you have studied Newton's law of gravitation. What is Newton's law of gravitation? Every particle in the universe attracts every other particle with a force that is proportional to the product of their masses and directly proportional, inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. This is the Newton's law of gravitation. Out of that, what did we understand is, In the entire universe, one particle can attract the other particle. In the way, see, about the Earth, if you consider Earth is a big planet, so Earth has a capacity to attract every object towards its center. You know that the force also, what is the force? That force is nothing but a gravitational force. See, now if I throw a chalk, why that is coming back? Because Earth is exerting some force on it and it is pulling towards its center. So this is what happens even in the case of a book. Is it not? When I try to balance it here or here, it is trying to fall down. It is not intergoing up. Why? Because the Earth is exerting some force on the book. Why it is? Because first of all, book is made up of what? Book is made up of atoms. Each and every atom of your book has some weight. See, let me explain you that how this happens. Consider again the book diagram, what have been taken. consider a book, it is made up of items, right?
Already I have told, book is made up of items, right?
even at my service. And you all know this, each atom is having a weight. Even we have understood, right? The earth is pulling each and every, earth is pulling all the atoms towards its center. We have studied that. Now, why I am not able to balance this book in the position A? Because, see here, the number of atoms which is towards your right side is less than that of what we mean by your left side. Can you see that? The number of atoms which is present is more in the case of towards your left side than in your right side. So that is the reason that I am not able to balance at the position A. I hope you have been understood. And even for conditions for the equilibrium, we have studied in the previous class. What is the conditions for the equilibrium? What is the second one? That is the algebraic sum of the moments due to weight W of each atom above the point A is not zero. See, sum of the moments at this point should be zero. Then only an object can be in equilibrium. If the sum of the moments above the point is not zero, it can never be in equilibrium. It is not equilibrium in the sense what happens. It will be moving either clockwise or anti-clockwise. So in the situation, if I try to balance the position A, how does the book fall? Book falls in the case of anti-clockwise direction. Book will fall in the case of anti-clockwise. And this is clockwise. So the book will not tilt towards clockwise. When I try to balance at the position A, the book will tilt towards anti-clockwise. Hence I can tell you that anti-clockwise moment is greater than the clockwise moment. Understand? Anti-clockwise moment is greater than the clockwise moment. Now I will consider case 2. Same way if you consider a book. If you consider a book, now let me consider the position B. So I have drawn an axis. So obviously you know that book is made up of atoms. So all these atoms are made up of which is being pulled by an atom in the form of weight. So the weight now is more towards your right side than compared to that of left side. So obviously now if I try to balance at the position B, why it is not able to balance or why it is not in the equilibrium condition? The reason is that because the weight is tilt towards, when you try to balance at position B, it will tilt towards what you mean by clockwise rather than anti-clockwise. And even the condition is same here, that is algebraic sum of the moments due to the weight W of each atom above the point B. Here it is above the point B. Above the point B is not zero. Above the point B is not zero. When it is not zero, what happens? That is here clockwise moment. Clockwise moment is greater than the clock and clockwise. Understand? I hope you have understood this case 1 and case 2. This is the reason I have explained you about the book, why it is made up of atoms and what you mean by weight, all this. Understand? If I try to hold a book in equilibrium at a position A, it is not possible. The reason is some of the atoms is very more towards your left side. So the book tilt towards what? Anti-clockwise moment rather than clockwise. In this case 2, the book will tilt towards clockwise rather than anti-clockwise. By looking into case 1 and case 2, you very well know that what the case 3 would have been. Let me explain you that also. See, in a case 3, consider a book. So, now I will consider the position G. See, when I take a position G here, this is the number of atoms. Look at me. Already you know these atoms.
Even it is not only towards your left and right. Even when you consider this both sides, also it is looking to the center. To all the four sides, this is a center position. So if I try to balance there, if I try to balance the book in this position G, it will be in equilibrium. Why it will be in equilibrium? Because some of the clockwise moments will be equal to the sum of the anti-clockwise moments will be equal to the sum of the clockwise moments. This is the concept behind what we mean by center of gravity. And this position G is nothing but center of gravity. There is a one position that where we can hold it in equilibrium. So in this case, what happens to this? That is the algebraic sum of the moments.
Means if all
the center of gravity. All the sum of the forces which is acting at this point is how much? It is zero. If it is zero, what happens? It will be in the case of equilibrium. Considering the body is zero, the entire weight of the body can be considered to act at this point, howsoever the body is being placed. You place the book even vertically, upwards, horizontally, anywhere. But the center of gravity never changes. Center of gravity remains. Understand? So this is the definition which is being given in the textbook. Take that. Now, very important, we will see that center of gravity is regular objects, which it is given, the list is being given in your textbook. Please go through that, because in your examination, even two, they can ask you for 2 marks. What is the center of gravity of a triangle? What is the center of gravity of a rectangle? Or what is the center of gravity of a disc? What is the center of gravity of a ring? Such sort of questions they are going to ask you for 2 marks, which is very important. Among which few have been showing now, what is the center of gravity? Here, I have considered a rod. What is the center of gravity of a rod? So, center of gravity of a rod is the midpoint of the rod. So, you have to write an answer. If they ask a question, what is the center of gravity of a rod? Your answer should be midpoint of the rod. You need not draw the diagram, just you need to make midpoint of the rod. Now we have a second one. We have taken circular ring and circular disc. Where does the center of gravity of a circular ring and a circular disc? Circular ring and a circular disc is geometric center. This is called as what? It is geometric center. One thing you notice here, see, in the case of the rod, it is all the particles, within the particle center of gravity present. But here, in a circular ring, see, for example, in this ring, if you consider, the center of gravity is a middle, which can be even away from the object or inside the object. Remember, this is the very important question they are going to ask you in the ICSE. Where does the center of gravity of circular ring and circular disc is present? Right. Center of gravity of circular ring and circular disc is a geometric center. Very important. Now, what is this center of gravity of triangular gravity? See, it is the intersection of medians. You all have done this, right? Midpoint theorem and all. See, in your mathematics, see, this is the point where the center of gravity of a triangle lies. So, that is called the point of intersection of medians. Now we have taken some rectangle, parallelogram, square. Look at here. It is the intersection of diagonals. Wherever you have taken, see, rectangle, parallelogram, what it is? It's a diagonal, what you write. So the intersection of diagonals are the center of gravity in case of rectangle, parallelogram, and square. So in your textbook, they have given nearly 15 objects, which is uniform shape. What is the center of gravity? Please learn that. It's a very important. Now what we will see that? We will see some important previously asked questions, application questions based on the topic center of gravity. So by that we can wind up today's class. We have this very important 3 questions which was previously asked examination in the topic of center of gravity. It's very easy. See, name the factors on which the center of gravity depends. We need to tell the factors on which center of gravity depends. So center of gravity depends on mass. Very important. And distribution of mass. It's entirely depends on distribution of mass. If distribution of mass are equal both towards clockwise and anti-clockwise, it will be equilibrium. Otherwise, it will not be. And third one also is very important. Size, shape, structure, and geometry. Does center of gravity for all the objects is same? No, not at all. It depends from object to object. That we have seen. For circle, it is different. For triangle, it is different. For rectangle, it is different. So, center of gravity depends on size, shape, structure, and geometry. Very important question it is. Second, does the center of gravity change when the body is deformed? See, what do you mean by deformed? It's obvious. Think that now I have taken a triangle. Center of gravity of a triangle is intersection of medians. Now, if I cut the triangle, if I cut the triangle or deform the triangle, does still the center of gravity remain the same? When you deform the body, center of gravity changes. So that is the question here. Does the center of gravity changes when the body is deformed? Yes, because center of gravity depends on what? Size, shape, structure, and geometry. You need to make the reason also. Most of you are writing only yes or no, that which you only 1 mark. Understand? And even you have to write yes or no, that is actually 1 mark. Without writing yes or no, don't write the reason. Right? These are the very, very important questions which you will ask. And the third one, very, very important question it is, can center of gravity be situated outside the meridian of the body? See, I have already told you. For example, if you consider a rod on a wire, center of gravity will be on the body. Center of gravity will be on the body. But when you consider a green boomerang and all, it is inside the body. Right? For example, if you consider circular wheel, center of gravity is at the middle. So that is the reason. Yes, center of gravity can be situated outside the material of the body. It can be situated even outside the material of the body. It is need not, it will be always within the material of the body. Very important. So which are the two examples for the ring? The ring, center of gravity is here, which is outside the body. Then boomerang. Boomerang is also the example. The center of gravity is at the middle portion. So these are the top three questions of what you mean by center of gravity. So still when the school opens, we will further discuss more about this center of gravity. If still any doubts you have raised, you are free enough to ask. So in the next class, we are going to move on uniform circular motion. Very interesting topic. So until then, take care.